Hey, what's up guys, it's Fishy and welcome back my glorious bannermen to an online battle on Napoleon Total War. This is a battle between me, Pixelated Apollo, Warrior Sparta, Alex Rambler and Lionheart. If you want to check out their channels, or if you haven't already, they'll be in the description down below. So, we've been wanting to play this battle for quite a while just because the sheer epicness of this map. Like, if you just take a little glimpse of Warrior Sparta's position, he kind of starts up on this massive hill where he can kind of plant his artillery on this ridge, which he's obviously going to do. And to kind of come down from that, you have to kind of follow this like goat's path, like this 300 goat's path down the hill. And then to actually assault us, you know, he has to come up these like central paths, which are kind of deadly. You know, we got one over there, and we can even stick our artillery up on this ridge, which, you know, is a perfect firing position down there. A perfect firing position down there. And he can also, you know, kind of fight back with Warrior's artillery up there. But, you know, if he wants to, if he doesn't want to, like, kind of attempt this, he can meet up with Rambler and Lionheart, who are kind of on the flanks, pretty easily by just marching up, you know, these other paths up here. You can see that Lionheart on this left-hand side has a really easy job at kind of getting to our forest. He kind of starts a lot closer. You know, same with Alex Rambler. He, you know, he's pretty quick. He just has to kind of traverse this little hill with these boulders in the way. You know, he can also go ahead and deploy further over here with his artillery, because he can also come and support Warrior in the center if he wants to. You know, there's paths up there where you can kind of support the assault. So we just thought this map was really, really cool. It kind of adds, you know, just some really interesting terrain with kind of like the own little mound over there. That's like a mini fortress over there with like these paths to actually defend outside the fortress. Like, I think these battles are really cool where you actually have to defend, you know, outside the fortress. You don't want to give up some defensive ground. So you're forced to kind of move outside the fortress and try and stop them from even getting close to your walls. Which I think is really, really cool. So we're going to quickly run through a few of the units and then we're just jumping into the battle. So me and Apollo are playing as the French and the Spanish. He is playing as the Spanish, I'm playing as the French. And we are defending this glorious, glorious fortress. We will not let it fall into enemy hands. So we have a whole bunch of Polish Legion, which I really, really like. I love their uniforms. They're just really cool. They're just really, really nice uniforms. I think it's the hats which really do it. The hats just make them look so epic. They really do. So, that's my main infantry line, was my Polish Legion. And then I have a unit of Swiss Guard, because I love having more Swiss and Polish Legion. I just kind of really like the whole mix-up of my army, that it's not just French troops to kind of doing it. You know, fighting in my wars. I have a whole bunch of other nations fighting in it. And I like to represent that by having Swiss Foot and Polish Legion in my army. Of course, I have Young Guard and Old Guard. They're just chilling around. I've got my Young Guard inside the city. Just looking lovely. I also have a unit of Rocket Artillery, which are just so epic. They're so good to have in a siege, especially for defenders, because you can pick away at large units, kind of trying to scale walls and stuff very easily. So having a unit of rockets is just really nice. I think actually Alex has a unit of rockets as well, which is going to be pretty deadly, kind of having some rocket offs. Some Apollo's Grenadiers, some Spanish Grenadiers, which are really, really obviously useful in a siege. They can throw grenades and just cause absolute devastation if they want to. If they can kind of land some good grenades. Some Fusiliers. And then also we kind of also defended some of our troops out here. Got some more Polish Legion out here to kind of defend this ridge. We do not want to give up this amazing fighting position. So I stuck out some Polish Legion. I also have a unit of Old Guard out here as well, which just look like, oh, this is one of my favorite units in the game. Look at them. That just looks absolutely glorious. Really, really does. The graphics of Napoleon just astound me how good they are. This isn't even on Ultra. This is on very high, I think, and there's one more level still to go. Does look absolutely amazing. So that's kind of our makeup. We have some fairly interesting troops. We put all our skirmishers out here because we wanted to put down stakes and kind of defend these like ridge points. We didn't want to get charged by cavalry up here. So we're going to stick all our skirmishers around here, kind of just deploy stakes and make this into a really nice fortified position. We have more skirmishers out here. I have my Voltaires. And Apollo has some of his skirmishers, which I'm not even going to try and pronounce because I'll probably butcher the name. Some of his dudes out here as well to go ahead and put down stakes. God, he has a top hat. What a posh fucking soldier. They all have top hats. Damn. I want to be in like their army. Because if I get a top hat, that would be pretty epic. You can see already the artillery just coming down. So Lionheart is playing as the Austrians, and he just has a bunch of Fusiliers as kind of his main infantry line. A whole bunch of them. Does he have any unique units we need to look at, or is it just mainly just Hungarian Fusiliers? Yeah, it pretty much is. His entire infantry line is just Hungarian Fusiliers, which is pretty funny. Here's some interesting men over here. Some Charles's Legion with their nice coats. 47 Czech Regiment are awesome. There's actually named regiments as well, which is really cool. That's one of the most appealing things about Napoleon, is just all the kind of different units and battalions and stuff. Is really cool. And then he has some First Emperor's Own, so these guys must be absolutely beast. Hopefully they're not a match for my old guard, but they might be. And he also obviously has some artillery over here. He has some 7-pounders and just 2 7-pounder howitzers, which I'm sure is going to be hurting us inside the city. You can probably already see them shooting right now, which is pretty brutal. Alex Rambler over here is playing as the Prussians. Some First East Prussian Grenadier Battalions, some Musketeers, and I think the rest of his line is just Musketeers. So he has some Grenadiers, he has some Musketeers. You know, it's going to be pretty hard for me and Apollo to kind of defend all these flanks at once. You know, if they time their attack right, it's going to be very hard for us. Then he has some Foot Guard, which of course are going to be elite infantry. Has some more Musketeers, some 8th Life Regiment. Sorry, my voice is a bit crackly today. I've only just woken up, but I wanted to get this recorded. So please, please bear with me. This battle does get epic. And if you don't want to see any of this, obviously just click that to battle annotation and you'll be able to get through all of this. But I just think looking over the armies and kind of seeing what we're working with is always interesting. And you can always skip it. There's no hassle there. Some more Foot Guard there. He also has some cavalry, some dragoons, which are going to be pretty potent if we try and assault anything. Finally, we'll look at Warrior Spartans battle army, and then we'll jump into this battle. So obviously you've got to bring the 42 of Foot, the Black Watch, such an epic British unit. One of my favourite. You've got to love the Scottish and their kilts. Just some more Foot Guard, just bunches of Foot Guard, kind of making up the whole main infantry line. More foot. God, he brought so much foot. I guess it is a pretty stable infantry. Then you've got your more elite Foot Guard. These guys are obviously better than the normal foot infantry. Looking crazy cool. Bought some rifles. Are these Sharp rifles? Are these 95th? No, these aren't 95th. I think 95th actually says they're 95th. So these are just rifles. Oh, it's some epic muskets. Look at that. Or rifles, I guess they are, not muskets. Really, really cool. Really nice design. Some King's German Legion. And then finally, he has some 6-pounders. So Lionheart actually bought heavier cannons. Also, finally, we'll quickly just show you what Rambler brought for his artillery. He bought 12-pounders. My God. He is not messing around. Rocket artillery. There's some more 12-pounders. Damn. He's got some pretty heavy artillery. So yeah, let's go ahead and jump into this battle. You can see the artillery already shattering around. I think this is Lionheart's artillery just trying to pepper us as best they can. Just trying to rack it up. You can see the sound is already going off. The artillery has come flying in already. And I think mine and Apollo's kind of main goal is just to get our artillery up on this ridge so we can kind of keep Warrior at bay. You know, if we can move this up. Oh, that's already missing. The rocket artillery is coming in. Damn. Actually trying to pick away at some of my cavalry. I had some Polish Legion Lancers, which I missed out on. Actually, in the forest, which I'm like, crap, I do not want these guys to get killed. So I'm just going to move them out a bit. Maybe try and harass Rambler a little bit. You can see Apollo's getting his artillery ready. Because this is such a good position, firing position. If they try to come up this ridge, Apollo's going to be able to absolutely just smash anything that does come in his way. And he can also turn into this. Oh, this is going to be painful. You know, luckily, artillery can actually sponge quite a bit of damage. Oh my god, no, that all hit the ground. No. Luckily, artillery can kind of sponge quite a bit of damage. So it's not really too bad. Hitting a few men, killing a few infantry units here. Oh yeah, also Rambler just wrecked his men. He shot a cannonball right through the line, which you can see there. Yeah, as I was saying, like, luckily... Artillery can kind of absorb a decent amount of damage. I'm trying to get my cavalry behind Rambler here to cause some harassment. And he does form square, which is going to be perfect targets for my artillery when once I kind of realize he's done that. For now, I'm just trying to take out his rocket artillery because it's going to be a bit annoying to deal with. But eventually, I give up on this. It just takes way too long to kill artillery in this game, unless you're obviously charging it with cavalry or something. So I'm going to kind of give up on my rocket artillery for now. And kind of just focus on killing his men. Because if I can kind of force him to come forward and attack us, it's going to be much better for us if we can kind of force them to attack us. Because right now, they have so many more men and so much more artillery. So they can really sit back and kind of just do as much damage as they want to us. So we need to kind of encourage them to come forward. And the best way to do that is just to start shooting their men with artillery.
Our men are running, sir.
Yeah, that's my cavalry got caught out by his dragoons, which I actually just missed. His dragoons came over and there's nowhere really for my Polish legion, my Polish lancers to go. They were kind of just stuck between a rock and a hard place, really. My artillery still going out for rockets. Devastating over there. Really is. I'm just trying to work out, trying to kill a few of these. I've done an okay job. I'm also bringing some of my skirmishes. Oh, actually, this is actually Apollo bringing some of his skirmishes onto this side to kind of make it a bit more defensible against Rambler. And we've kind of put down all these stakes now to really give us a good position. And Apollo's brought up his artillery. He's got some 12 pounders over here. Oh, that was epic. Got some of his 12 pounders.
Our general is under attack.
Shooting away at Warrior's line. Just trying to rack up any kills he can right now. You know, from a distance, we don't really expect to kill too many. But this is just such a cool firing position. You know, a lot of Warrior's shots are actually missing. Oh, epic. You know, whereas ours, oh, look at the wood just getting wrecked. You know, where a lot of our shots have a cleaner target to actually shoot at. So this is a really nice firing position. And we have it pretty well defended as well. So there's no real rush there. And at the moment, they're kind of just sitting back. You know, they're letting us shoot our rockets and our artillery. Because they really need to make some breaches in these walls. God, these 7-pounder howitzers look beastly. Look at that. That's an absolute monster. So at the moment, they're just shooting us as much as possible. And we're kind of just reforming the line. Apollo's artillery over here is not doing a great job. They're kind of hitting a lot of the ground. And I think this is where Rambler tries to take on my rocket artillery. But again, he doesn't really do too much. And I'm kind of focusing on killing his infantry now. Because if I can get Rambler to go ahead and be like, oh crap, I'm losing actually a decent amount of men. I can do what he's doing now. You know, he's forced to attack because he doesn't want to sit back and just get shot by rocket artillery. You know, but however, you know, getting shot by rocket artillery and waiting for everyone else to get into position would have been a good idea. But, you know, because of my own rocket artillery forcing him to push his entire line forward, you know, he's now encouraging the rest of his teammates to actually attack as well. This entire time, my rocket artillery is just picking away slowly. You know, 79 in that unit, 111 in that unit. Yeah, these numbers are dropping, and this is forcing them to attack prematurely. You know, now Warrior's having to come off his heel before they've even made any breaches. He's marching down with his foot guard. Because to actually look at it, Warrior's got quite a distance to actually travel, to actually make it on top of his hill, and to actually be in a good position to assault. So he's going to have to be marching, and if Alex isn't careful, he's going to start attacking way too soon before anyone else is even positioned. Lionheart's doing a really good job of taking down this wall. It's up to 66% now, so he should be able to create a really nice breach soon. And that's going to give him a nice attacking point for sure. But again, like, he's not moving, and Rambler is. You know, Lionheart's sitting there with his fusiliers waiting for the wall to be broken. Whereas our artillery is kind of forcing Alex to come forward. And obviously it'd be much better if we could kind of fight two battles instead of three. You know, if we fight a battle on three sides, we're going to be in a much better position than fighting it on... Yeah, I mean, sorry. If we can kind of force one engagement early... Oh, the artillery just wrecked that dude. If we can force an engagement early, it's going to be much better for us. Oh my god, this unit is getting wrecked! The skirmishes from Apollo just going in. 61 in this grenadier battalion, which is not what you really want to be having fighting skirmishes as grenadiers. Could they actually have a lot fewer men in the unit, so every man kind of counts a lot more, whereas in a foot unit you have 120, so you kind of have that extra 30 men buffer. So you kind of want to save these guys for melee or throwing their grenades. The rocket artillery as well coming in the distance, just picking away at men, really forcing these guys forward. Apollo's going to do a really, really smart move and kind of fall back. And Rambler doesn't really want to chase too far because he just wanted to come in range of our fortress cannons. And I think I also brought a unit of skirmishers over as well to go ahead and help out. Oh yeah, I also brought some spikes as well to kind of defend away from Rambler's dragoons. So the rocket artillery is really causing Rambler a lot of problems. So that's only one person it's causing problems with. Warrior and Lionheart really aren't kind of receiving too much missile fire from us. So their units are really fresh. So kind of at the moment, Rambler's just kind of like the sacrificial lamb. You know, he's losing a few men, but it's biding everyone else a lot of time to kind of form up into their positions. Damn, look at all the dead bodies here as well. 103 of them now. That's pretty brutal. But yeah, as I said, you know, that's not bad. You might be losing men and the pressure might be on you. But, you know, as long as everyone else is fine, you know, they still outnumber us pretty heavily. You can see the balance of power is really against us. Well, not really against us, but slightly against us. You know, all they have to do is bide a warrior enough time to kind of form up with Lionheart. And then they'll be in a really, really good situation. Because warrior did a really smart decision. You know, he decided not to attack this central point, even though it'd look really cool trying to attack up here. It's just not feasible to do because it's such a, you know, two real big choke points. We have kind of a high ground with our artillery to kind of shoot down off these ridges. So he's doing a really smart move and moving up and actually meeting up with Lionheart because Lionheart's just about to create a breach. Perfect timing. He's just about to create a breach over here, which you can now push through. So he's decided, you know, Rambler's like, come on guys, I'm getting shot to pieces. I need you guys to come help me. I need you guys up here and start attacking because we need to kind of stop silence this rocket artillery from shooting. So Lionheart's like, yeah, cool. I'm going to start moving up my Jaegers and my Fusiliers. But I also have my skirmishers actually in the woods shooting on this advancing force. I'm getting hit by howitzers. I'm going to receive some shots from his Jaegers. Obviously, I'm heavily outnumbered here, but I'm bringing up the old guard up on this ridge to help me out. If I can get my old guard to start shooting. We're so close as well. This is just... it's going to be good for me. Because we're a lot closer to these skirmishers. Meaning we can slaughter them like we're doing. You know, but look at that, them Jaegers just drop. But because he has so many more... oh, brutal! Because he has so many more Jaegers, eventually his firepower is just going to overwhelm him. Now he's got the rest of his Fusiliers shooting up on this ridge. And even though I have old guard up here, you know, that eventually the firepower of four units plus skirmishers is going to be too much for me. You know, because we kind of don't have a real defended flank. The old guard are eventually just going to get surrounded and probably killed, you know. Me, I've kind of isolated this unit and they're going to be defending, you know, they're going to be standing till 40 men, you know. They're definitely standing, but it's definitely going to be a waste of them. You know, they managed to hold till 28, which is not bad whatsoever, considering they got absolutely surrounded. And that was really, really nice by Lionheart. So I kind of don't want to give up that hill quite yet, so I'm going to move two units of my Polish Legion over to his flank. Rambler has also pushed up his entire line now that everyone else is attacking. We've got our skirmishers kind of picking off a few of them on this ridge. Just picking off a few of these men trying to get up onto this thing, onto the wall. Some of my Swiss foot now opening up. I forgot to also put my skirmishers into skirmish mode, so they're actually standing and shot in the back by mistake. My Polish Legion are also defending this little bridge. Between, because if I can kind of create a nice little firing zone, I finally realize I'm sticking in skirmish mode now. You know, if I can kind of close this gap at the moment, you know, he can't really get too many more rifles to bear because we're kind of in a shorter distance. So if I can just straight up, you know, close the angle, I can kind of almost just match him gun for gun. Because I'll have as many lines as he does firing. But obviously he has a lot of skirmishers. So I am starting to lose this a bit, so I actually want to kind of bring back my men a little bit. Just to try and reduce the angle. And obviously shooting from out here as well, my Swiss foot and my skirmishers. Really going to be helping me out. Just it's just the sheer mass. Obviously they can have 60 units and we can only have 40, so just the sheer mass of their army is just gonna be helping them out. You know, if they can kind of create these longer engagements where they can get flanks and stuff, it's gonna be pretty good for them. God, these battles are so epic. They really are so epic. You've got men actually shooting up onto the wall as well. Some of the Charles Legion and the Emperor's Zone and the 47 Czech. Oh, it looks so cool as well with the rifles just peeking up over the walls. That looks so epic. It really does. Rambler has finally made another breach over here with his artillery, which is a really good, really, really good. And he tries to charge in with some cavalry, but it doesn't really get too effective. There's a unit of grenadiers back here and a unit of grenadiers actually holding the line here. Which is nice because having grenadiers in melee, they're always better than normal guard units. So they're going to be able to volley. Oh, look at that. Brutal. With the rocket artillery coming in as well. Really, really nice. We get some good screenshots here. And here they come charging in. Come on, boys. Please fire one more time. Oh, absolutely epic. Really, really cool. And Apollo's going to get a really, really epic grenade throw off. Like, this is going to be crazy cool. Getting his grenades out. They're loading them. Because one unit of grenadiers is holding it. Oh, look at that. That's going to be so big. So big. Oh, my lord. Crazy. Look at that smoke. And he can keep doing this as well. Keep throwing grenades over here. That's going to be devastating for the morale of the Prussian troops. I'm sure he's throwing some more over again. Very soon. They're currently reloading as well. The melee is far off, but these grenadiers are born for this hand-to-hand combat with muskets. You know, this is what they excel at. Rifles shooting overhead as well. Rocket artillery coming in. And we're making sure that we're using our rocket artillery as best as possible. They are starting to push up now. They managed to kind of push back my Polish Legion. Obviously, they can eventually just outgun me, and it's just not going to be in my favor. You know, they have more skirmishers and more riflemen. So it's going to be a lot more brutal. Oh my god, I love this camera shake. It just looks so amazing. It really does. Absolutely epic. So they're going to be volleying away at my Swiss foot. My Swiss foot are going to be shooting back as best they can. I'm just trying to hold this position. We don't want to give up the walls and we don't want to give up the gates. You know, at the moment, we are actually losing a few men up here. But it's not too bad. Especially if the artillery fire is not helping us too much. But we're getting some really good shots off with rocket artillery. Picking off a few of them over there, you saw. And my Polish Legion are finally gone now. Which kind of opens up this entire area if they wanted to. Apollo's Grenadiers managed to hold the line as well and push them back. Volleying as best they can at the routing troops. And Rambler still does have a decent force. He's trying to climb up here as well. But it didn't go too well for him. The Prussians are routing. Losing his general as well really, really hurt him. Really, really hurt. But now they've kind of taken out this outer breach. You know, we were kind of defending it as best as possible. And now that they've actually taken it, it's going to be pretty painful for us. They can kind of control the entirety of the outside of a fortress now. Beforehand, we were kind of, you know, holding parts of the fortress which like were outside, kind of preventing them from actually fully climbing up onto our walls and stuff. But now they kind of have free reign to do what they want. I also decided to bring a unit of guard seamen out here. Guard seamen gets me every time. I decided to bring a unit out here because they start actually traversing the walls, and if I can start getting some volleys off into here, which I'm going to be doing. I can actually start getting some really nice kills, which you can see them just dropping. That's my guard seamen volleying away. Reloading as they climb up the walls. As you can see there, they're really clumped up. So you can just see them dropping.
Our men are running, sir.
Oh, absolutely epic. Yeah, volleying, dropping loads of them as they're so clumped up. When I start getting hit, you know, from the side, from the Hungarian Fusiliers, so I need to kind of back off here because it's not going to be in a good situation. You know, if I can get in this choke point, kind of protects my flank a little bit, and they bring over loads. Warrior Sparta's now here with his foot guard. Or just his foot, my mistake. And they can really start pushing on their assault, fighting up here, fighting on the walls. If they take the walls, it's going to be really nice because they can start shooting down. But we still have a massive amount of men actually over here. Just wrecking anyone coming through that gate. You know, we have a really nice firing range over here. Turns into a massive melee here. Oh no, I missed another grenade throw. There was another grenade throw over here, which I must have missed, where Apollo actually threw his grenades and Lionheart saw it and actually advanced his... Oh my god, look at them all coming in. And actually advanced his infantry line, so they kind of exploded behind him. It was so epic. Damn, absolute madness. The rocket artillery. On this side, Rambler's kind of having a hard time of it. He's slowly whittling down the Grenadiers because Apollo actually had to bring some more men away. But it's not that bad for us. We still have these Fusiliers over here. We have my old guard defending this little townhouse over here. Some young guard over here. Like, me and Apollo are starting to run out of men. You know, but their huge numbers are starting to actually win the day. But because we're kind of using these choke points nice and effectively, it's not looking too bad for us. And they actually finally take the gate. Their Fusiliers actually managed to go ahead and... Oh no, it's actually the Emperor's own take the walls and actually take this gate. Meaning they can transfer troops through the gatehouse. However, this might not always be the smartest idea. But we're starting to set up like a firing range here. So anything comes through this gate is going to get hit by 4 units. 2 units of Fusiliers, a unit of light infantry, some young guard, and a unit of Polish Legion. So even though taking these walls is really effective, it's going to be pretty brutal moving anything through that gate. So we just need to keep on taking this wall. You know, they have a bit more defensive positions, you know, not all their bodies showing, so a lot of bullets are actually going to miss. Oh, epic! Look at that coming up there! Coming up the walkway, that's so cool! Just trying to take back this from the king, the emperor's own. Some Fusiliers trying to take it back as best they can. Rocket artillery still shooting. They're starting to move in some Charles legions and some foot guard. I do actually have my Polish legion over here volleying into them as they try and come over. You know, that's a good thing about having sieges, a fortress. There's a load of choke points, and unless you attack from multiple like kind of positions, you're kind of forced into this choke point where we can kind of bring a lot more guns to bear than they can. They're going to start pushing through as best they can through the gatehouse. Trying just to stop our units from shooting. You know, Lionheart tried to go ahead and just engage all our infantry to stop them from shooting so that Warrior could move through his entire foot line. Like, he's bringing through massive amounts of men right now. Just piling in. Which, if Lionheart's charge would have got off, it would have been kind of effective. But now, they're really compact. And our Polish Legion are along the lines... You know, along with the Fusiliers and the light infantry. You know, we just have a really nice firing position. They even needed just to push through that gate and just charge at us and just overwhelm us in numbers. Or they just needed to not really come through this gatehouse, because at the moment, they're just getting picked apart by our Polish Legion and Fusiliers. You know, the young guard has started to turn now as well. The rocket artillery is coming in. Actually hitting us in the back. First, obviously, Ramblers, rocket artillery. Just absolutely brutal. But you can't say no to the English. The English are trying their best to push through that gate. They're determined. I've got my guard seam as well, shooting the men, trying to go in as well. So this pulling morale is not going to be helping. Actually bringing up some more of my guard seam and just keep on getting a nice flanking shot. The Emperor's Own are starting to get pushed back now. The Fusiliers is just overwhelming them up here. Then again, there's not many fusiliers left, so they probably will hold it up. There's some massive rocket artillery here. It's not really finding any massive targets. But, you know, if they did find it, it would have been pretty epic. I actually go ahead and throw some of my, I think, old guard or young guard actually into this little barracks. Go ahead and give us a really nice defensive position. They're not going to be hitting many shots there, and we're going to be getting some really good shots. But you can see this push is starting to, you know, kind of be a bit potent. They're starting to get a whole bunch of men through. They kind of just need to charge us and kind of overwhelm us in the melee. Instead of going for this little shooting off, because we kind of have the arc right now. We're kind of whittling them down. Go ahead and throw in some of my Polish Legion to engage this and hopefully overwhelm the British 88 foot. The Connacht Rangers are awesome. Connacht Rangers, the Irish. Is that not Irish? I don't know. I'm pretty sure Connacht is an island. God, my geography is awful. I apologize if I'm wrong. But that's awesome. But even though they're routing, gonna move my Polish Legion. Because again, if I can get these guys to stop shooting, the rest of our infantry will just overwhelm them. Massive fighting up here. The Emperor's Own slowly getting overwhelmed by the light infantry and the fusiliers. Now this kind of just turned off into this massive melee at the gate. And you know, the balance of power is starting to turn into our favor. We're starting to rout the English. Losing their generals really hurt. You know, my Polish Legion over here is kind of starting to advance on the rest of the English, kind of trying to pour through here. Same with Apollo. Apollo's fusiliers are moving up as well. The rocket artillery is really hurting morale. The King's German Legion. Trying just to rack up as many kills. But you can see, because they're kind of forced into this choke point, a lot of their rifles aren't actually shooting. And we can have these really long lines. You know, shooting from up here in the barracks. You know, shooting along this massive line. Shooting over there with my Polish Legion. You know, defending these fortresses is just giving us a really nice defensive position. And we're kind of just forcing the Legion just to run away. And they're just getting picked apart by my Polish Legion. Losing a few men here. Look at the death and destruction here. Look how many dead Englishmen died here trying to get through this gate. That's pretty brutal. You know, obviously we did lose a lot of men as well. Along here. You know, there's plenty of dead fusiliers here. A bunch of Lionheart's dead Hungarian fusiliers. And just a crazy amount of dead Englishmen. The King's Legion routing. Losing their general obviously didn't help. 47th is ready to hold one last time. But the battle is starting to look in our favour. You know, me and Apollo are starting to run out of men. Rambler kind of didn't really manage to push through this gap. Obviously bringing my young guard out of the thing and my old guard out of this fortress really helped kind of suffice him, and we kind of managed to kill him fully. And it doesn't look like the enemy actually have too much left now. You know, Lionheart has some skirmishes left, but not really too much. My guard seamen are just going to charge down and kill their artillery. Because we don't want to be charging that with canister shots, so I'm just trying to get rid of this as soon as I can. Really nice charge, and we should make quick work of this artillery crew. The guard seamen are taking the pleasures of war now, chanting, slaughtering. You know, these guys are not going to stand up against my guard seamen. That guy just did a really awesome 12, though. You can see they're already routing. Cheers, my men. And there's just little pockets of resistance, you know, a few foot guard left. Which are about to get some nice volleys off of these light infantry. The light infantry is going to get the charge off. Yeah, straight into the back. And this foot guard, not, you know, it's extremely tired. You've got to remember, Warrior came from all the way over there. He had to march from that little ridge all the way down here just to get up here. So his men are going to be exhausted kind of climbing all this distance. Just kind of killing these last pockets of resistance. Did the Emperor's Own finally get killed? Yeah, the Emperor's Own finally died on the walls. And it's looking pretty good for us. There's not really too much. You kind of see where my Polish Legion held the line and died. Especially this unit over here. My god, they got slaughtered. Well, they didn't get slaughtered. They did a really good job of holding them up. And kind of biding us some time. Just the death and destruction on these hills. So I'm bringing over some Polish Legion just to kind of kill whatever's left. I don't think there's much left now. I think we pretty much routed all, but I think it's just Rambler's artillery. So we'll go ahead and speed things up just to kind of finish it. Because I think, because Rambler actually disconnected and lost connection, so his artillery kind of just carried on shooting. It's going to be AI shooting it. So we're just going to go deal with that. I'm going to send out my young guard to kind of finish the battle. But yeah, if we just look at the death, like, them grenades were insane over here by Apollo. Man, that was crazy cool.
A glorious victory, sir.
And just look at the death and destruction here. So many dead. So many dead. But, you know, me and Apollo managed to hold off. Just about, though. We were really, like, it does look like we have a fair amount left. But we really don't. Like, I had maybe, like, two or three units of full infantry. Like, maybe if they didn't lose their generals early on, they could have put up a much better fight. Like, their men would have actually maybe would have stayed around. And maybe if attacking from the back would have been a good idea as well, kind of stretching us on the walls. But still, nonetheless, they put up an amazing fight, and it was an absolutely epic fight. So, yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this Napoleon online battle. I think it maybe might even be my first online battle on Napoleon, which is pretty crazy. So, yeah, let's go ahead and look at the stats. I killed 1,400, or almost 1,500, Viva la France, and only lost 800. Apollo also killed 1,300, and Warrior Spartan just had a really tough time kind of moving his men from that ridge all the way over here. They were kind of exhausted, and Rambler was obviously encouraging them to attack because he was getting shot to pieces, so he needed something to happen. So, you know, the rocket artillery really kind of was the MVP. It kind of forced them to attack us when they could have just waited a little bit longer. Lionheart killing 865, kind of making up for his allies. See, did anyone kill a lot? German, the Guard Seaman killed 133. That's not bad. Polish Legion killing 208. Rockets killing 275. Nice. Anyone else doing too great? Young Guard did pretty decent, 158. Skirmishers did pretty poorly, but I didn't really use them very effectively. The old guard did not kill do too many either. You know, that old guard unit got slaughtered. That was the one over here on my ridge. But this old guard didn't. Lost 5, killed 65. That's not a bad KDA whatsoever. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this battle. I had so much fun recording and playing it. It was just such a cool battle. Them grenades, my god. It's a lot about Napoleon. You know, the shaking camera, the explosion. And you can kind of watch the cinematic shooting as well fairly effectively. Because, you know, they're not charging. There's not a lot going on. People are stationary and shooting. So, it's actually really fun to record. God, my Polish guard lance has got no kills. I am bad. I am extremely bad. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, make sure to drop a like and a comment, and also subscribe if you haven't already. Make sure to obviously check out everyone else in this video, and I'll see you guys next time. And peace out.